सही में ओके ओके यस मैडम आई एम रेडी
चेक दिस सर
यस आई एम रेडी मैडम
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ नेशनल एजुकेशन सोसाइटी रजिस्टर कर्नाटक श्री नागराजप्पा चेयरमैन ऑफ लोकल मैनेजिंग कमिटी एईएस नेशनल कॉलेज डॉक्टर जीबी पांडुरंग नायक प्रिंसिपल एईएस नेशनल डिग्री कॉलेज डॉक्टर एमबी कृष्णमूर्ति प्रिंसिपल एईएस नेशनल पीयू कॉलेज वी आर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दिस वेबिनार मीट आई एम सुप्रिया नायक एमके डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स वेलकमिंग वन एंड ऑल फॉर द गेटवे ऑफ रिसर्च वेबिनार मीट आई एम हैंड ओवरिंग टू अवर वाइस प्रिंसिपल and HOD of Department of Physics, Professor V. Jagdish. Sir.
Thank you, Supriya. Webinar sabhi namaskara. Good morning to one and all. Myself, Professor V. Jagdish, HOD of Physics, AS Nairi College, Gauri Vidhanur. Today we are organizing webinar meet, an initiative by IQASE, and the topic is gateway to research. We are always having the inspiration and support of Dr. A. H. Ram Rao, President, NES of Karnataka, and Professor S. N. Nagaraj Reddy, Honorary Secretary, NES of Karnataka. They are always with us in such explorations, and we are extremely thankful to them. On behalf of National College, and also I welcome Dr. M. V. Krishnamurthy, Governing Member, Principal, ASPU College, Gauri Vidhanur. And I welcome all the teaching faculty, friends from other institutions to this.
ಸರ್ ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಿ ಬಿ ಪಾಂಡುರಂಗ ನಾಯಕ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಗೌರಿ ಬಿದ್ದೂರ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನ ವತಿಯಿಂದ ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲಾಗಿದೆ ಮೊಟ್ಟ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ಸಂಗೀತಾ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಸಂಗೀತಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಅವರು ಕೂಡ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡಿದರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿಗೆ ಇಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಮಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿದೆ ಚೇತನ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರು ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟಿನ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹಾಗೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ನಾನು ಉತ್ಪೂರ್ತವಾದಂತಹ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಹಾಗೇನೆ ಇಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಧ್ಯಾಪಕರು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಮನವಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಈಗ ಓವರ್ ಟು ಚೇತನ್ ಸರ್
ಟುಡೇ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟುಮಾರೋಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಎನ್ನುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಮಾತಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಮಾತಿಗೆ ಅನುಗುಣವಾಗಿ ಗೌರಿಬಿದನೂರು ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಆಯೋಜಿಸಿರುವಂತಹ ಈ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತರಿರುವಂತಹ ಮಾನ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಂಶುಪಾಲರೇ ಉಪ ಪ್ರಾಂಶುಪಾಲರೇ ಐಕ್ಯುಎಸ್ಇ ಕೋಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟರ್ ಅವರೇ ಹಾಗೂ ವಿವಿಧ ಭಾಗಗಳಿಂದ ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಗಳಿಂದ ಈ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗಿಯಾಗಲು ಆಗಮಿಸಿರುವಂತಹ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳೇ ಹಾಗೂ ಗುರುವೃಂದದವರೇ ಆನ್ ಆಸ್ಪಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯು ಆಲ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ start my presentation. I just wanted to check whether my audio is clear. And throughout the presentation, I request all the participants to keep their videos on. I repeat, please, all of you, keep your videos on and audio mute. Through the course of this presentation, you want to interact with most possible people, because I don't want a one-way traffic to one. That is why the host of this webinar, once please give the instructions to turn on the videos and keep the audio off throughout the webinar. I hope I'm clear with this fact. Supriya Madam, is my audio clear? Can I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Madam. Thank you, Madam. Thank you. Well, to all my participants, I wish a pleasant morning once again. We have gathered here on this online platform to attend a webinar which is based on a most important, essential, and a pivotal concept that is required for the students of this generation, that is importance of research. Well, in this webinar, I'm going to show you few aspects of research, how the students should empower themselves in order to get into the field of research. That is why the topic of today is entitled as Gateway to Research. My dear participants, let us be ready. Let us listen to whatever I speak. And also we shall interact, share our ideas, exchange our views in order to get a fair idea of research. Well, my first slide and the very basic question which comes to mind is, what is research? I think I can ask few of the persons. Host, can you please check who is using that annotation symbol? Please have that. In the settings, you can see the names of the annotators. Please check them once. Well, I see few names, and I would like to interact with the participants who are appearing on the screen. Can Ramya KV unmute yourself? Start your video. Ramya KV. Ramya KV, no, I'm not getting her on. Yes, Ramya, can you please unmute yourself? Ramya, can you hear me? Can you listen to me? Yes, Ramya, according to me, what is research? Research andre enamma? You tell me what you know. Any idea, Ramya? Please share the idea. This is not an examination. Don't worry. Yaru illi tappu helidre shiksha kodadilla. This is just an exchange of ideas. ಕೇಳಿಸಿಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜೋರಾಗಿ.
ನಾವೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಅದನ್ನ
ಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಬೋದಾ? ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯು. ಓಕೆ ರಮ್ಯ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್. ಸರ್, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಟಿ ನರಸಿಂಹಯ್ಯ ಸರ್, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್. ಕೆನ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸರ್? Host of the session, madam and sir, can you please mute the participants from whom the sound is coming? Well, thank you, madam. Sir, I see the name as Principal Basuraj. Sir, can you please unmute yourself for a while? Sir is trying to unmute himself.
Yeah, yes, sir. It's unmuted. Yes,
sir, I would like to listen to your input on the question. What is research?
Sir, research is finding a new information which is not known.
Oh, thank you, sir. In this exercise, I got responses from two persons. One younger student and an elder person, and I saw two responses. One person said research is searching. The other person said research is finding out something which is not existing. Well, I am going to place two definitions of research here. Here to bare bare rithiyalli. And I'll also connect those definitions to a sort of a movie scene which all of us have noticed. Here comes the first definition. And I'll try to confine the concept of the webinar to the scientific research, because I've been told by the organizers that the majority of this people participating in this webinar are from the science background. So one standard definition by a book called as Introduction to Behavioral Research by Kerlinger, which was published in the year 1986, it states as scientific research is the systematic, controlled, empirical and critical investigation of natural phenomena, guided by theory and hypothesis about presumed relation among such phenomena. If I quote these definitions in front of our students, I'm pretty sure no one will understand such a long and complicated definition. This is like asking what is a machine in the movie Three Idiots, where one character in the movie gives a complicated definition which most of the people do not understand. So in order to make the definition easier, I'm going to place a contrary view where Amir Khan's role in the movie Three Idiots, he says the definition of a machine is anything which makes the life easier and saves time is a machine. I think when we are addressing such issues, providing the knowledge to our students about the future research ideas and all, it's essential for us to give them a simplified view, yet comprising all the concepts of the topic there. So according to me, scientific research is asking the question. We all being the students of National College, we are used to this idea. Prashnisade oppabedi annuvantadanna naavu muncheyinda Dr. H. Narasimhayyanavara asmiteyinda naavu kalthukolta bartha idivi. So asking a question is not new for us. In the scientific research, the first thing which we have to inculcate is the habit of asking the question. One question can lead to a discovery and an invention. Then analyzing the happening. You know, in the previous one also I told it is the investigation of natural phenomena. So that detailed and critical analysis, what is happening, why it is happening, how it is happening, by what virtue it is happening for any concept, has to be analyzed properly and ultimately assimilating the consequence. Whatever results are obtained, those things have to be assimilated. Applications have the same have to be found out, and then we shall proceed in order to know about the next ideas of how to proceed about. So I think this definition of scientific research will be better to convey the idea. Having said that, dear participants, let me move on to the next slide. I will ask a question, why research? Of course, I am told that most of the participants are students of BSc. Then for the students of science, the question of why is very, very important. It's not that we agree to each and every point, but we disagree at, we demand a result, we demand an explanation for each and everything. So at this point, again, I would like to ask few of the participants. I request once again to turn on the videos because I want to just see who are all the students and who are all the teachers. I just want to interact with more of the students. I see a name called as Kirtika here. Kirtika, can you unmute yourself and speak to me for a while? Host can unmute the person, those names I call out. Kirtika. And other names are also here. Sushmita NS. Sushmita NS, can you unmute me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Sushmita. Why do you want to do research if you want to? What is your motive for the research?
To be advanced.
To be advanced. Any other input, Sushmita? Can anyone else voluntarily answer to my question? What is the necessity of research? Manjunath SV, sir, can you please unmute and give your idea on this? Why is research important and why do we have to take up research?
Sir, can I tell?
Yes, sir. Yes.
To increase the stock of knowledge in humans and culture and to improve the new technology like that.
Oh, very good. Harish YV is your name, right?
Yeah.
Yes, good one. Good point you have made. Before I move on to my idea why the research has to be done, can anyone of you give your input at this point?
That is useful to society, sir.
Yes, sir. Can you please repeat?
And we want to improve our knowledge and human. We want to improve our knowledge. And also is useful to our society also.
Useful to the society. Very good. Very good inputs. Please mute yourself, sir. So there are no disturbances. Well, I would like to place few examples. I have this habit of searching the logic behind everything. So when someone comes and tells us research has to be done, research is very important, the very first question which comes in my mind is why? Why one has to do research? What is the benefit of research? For that, let me try to answer in my own way. I have an image. I hope this appears on the screen. Vijay sir, I hope you have seen these kinds of phones earlier. Sir, can you hear me? I think the network issue persists. Which, sir, I hope faculties, elder people in the group would have seen this kinds of phone. This is an image of one of the earlier available mobile phones. Now, let me give you the idea how the mobile phones of today looks like. I'm not just speaking in terms of the view, in terms of appearance, rather in terms of technology. The fate of mobile phones has evolved so much. We have access to so many type of mobile phones now. And also I can say mobile phones have replaced many other devices. It has replaced an alarm clock. It has replaced a camera. All these things have been done because of the mobile phone. Why this has happened? Because of a continuous research that has happened in that particular domain. Well, dear participants, all of you listen to me now at this point. After the webinar gets over, you will get an e-certificate. For the e-certificate to be issued to you, you need to select a code. I repeat, you need to select a code. There's some background noise coming. Let me wait for a moment. Yes, you need to type a code without which the e-certificate will not be issued. I repeat, code has to be typed or you have to select in the form. The code will be split into three parts. Every now and then I'll be giving you the parts of the code. So it is very essential to note, it is a 6-letter code. The first two letters of the code would be yes to. I will just use the annotation option and write on the screen. The first code that has to be written is yes to, capital letter yes, and 2 is the number. All of you please make note of this. These are the first two letters of the code. Other 4 letters will be told to you at the later stages. Only if you select this proper code in the proper order, only then the certificate would be issued. I hope this is clear. I shall move forward with this. This is one example, the evolution that has happened in the field of telecom industry, mobile phone industry. Let me continue. Can anyone of you tell me what is this image? Can someone unmute yourself and tell me image enu anta? Or else again I will have.
Which one, sir?
Yes, sir.
Car, sir.
It's a car. What, sir?
It's a car. Car, sir. One of the earliest cars.
One of the earliest cars. Very good, very good. I think all of you are students who are so enthusiastic. Can you identify which company's car it is?
I think Rolls-Royce, sir.
No, not Rolls-Royce. You can identify in the image itself. Anyone?
Ford.
Yes, it's the car, one of the earliest cars which was given by Ford company. You can see the logo here. But as of today, if we say Ford does not have any cars like this, it has much developed versions of Ford. Again, in this field, research has played a very important role in getting what we have today. One very intriguing and familiar example I would like to give here. Can you tell me what is this image? Anyone? This is an image of a classroom, earlier classroom. The instrument which is being used there is a OHP, overhead projector, where transparent sheets were used, focused, and those images were able to see on a screen and all. But as of now, in today, we have evolved so much and we are in an online session. In an online virtual platform, all of us are appearing. Of course, this is the image of today's presentation itself. At least, dear students and participants, in the time where COVID-19 pandemic outbreak has happened and the whole of medical industry is putting their effort so hard to find a vaccine and a medicine for this virus, research will get its due respect. Research is very important. That is why in most of the establishments, it is not called just as research. Instead, it is called as research and development wing. Whenever research is there, it definitely leads to a development. That is why being the students of science, communicators of science, and those who are all having the benefits of the science education, it is very important for us to take up research. Again, as a few of the participants gave their insights to contribute back to the society, I think research would be a very good platform. Having said that, dear participants, let me move ahead to the next concept. I think I shall erase this S2. This is the first code. I hope all of you have made note of this. Yes. Yes. Let me move ahead. The concept which I am going to declare in the next slides is very, very important for the students. For students of undergraduation, this might be a new knowledge. For students of post-graduation, it might be an extra knowledge. And for the faculty members, this is already a known thing. It might be an additional one. What are the stages of the research? I have split the stages of research into three parts. The first part, when we want to get into the research, lot of confusions happen. We are not having the knowledge of how to go about, where to start, how to start, whom to approach, what to approach. Lot of confusions persist. That is why I put an image of a maze. Once we enter the maze, it's definitely hard for us to come back. And we don't know where we will get lost. We don't know what will be the final destination. Such is the field of research. Then the question appears, how to start about with the research? What has to be my idea? What has to be my preparation? For that, I have given few points, dear participant. I don't want to confuse you with abundance of ideas. Instead, few simplistic views I'm going to put forward so that you might be getting some idea how to go about this with this. First thing is, identification of area of research that has to be made out of your interest and possibility. I would like to spend a few minutes here. When you are trying to identify the area of research, your passion matters, your interest matters, your knowledge matters. I cannot ask a person who has studied arts, psychology, history subjects like this throughout his life to do a research on chemistry, which is a hardly possible thing. Again, for us, the students of science, it might not be that easier to pursue music, dance, or some other performing arts as a research. What is our interest? What are our strengths? What are our weaknesses? We have to give thoughts on these aspects while identifying the area of research. When in this process, dear students, especially this is a insight for all the students, once we step into the master's degree or the doctoral degree research and all, the fields become interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, transdisciplinary. By quoting these words, I mean, if you have studied physics in your undergraduate and master's degree, don't expect physics to be the only subject you will have to pursue in the future. You will need the knowledge of chemistry, you will need the knowledge of computer science, you will need the knowledge of electronics, even biology, all those things. That's what I'm telling. Research is interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, transdisciplinary. In one or other way, all these three words might mean the same. Look at your strengths. Tell me about the possibility. I mean to say, possibility, it should be a measurable one. We should have access to everything and then step into the field of research. Otherwise, if we have an aim or if we have an idea of doing something which is not at all possible, then there's no point of getting into research at all. Again, I'm going to give you an example of my own experience, how I did this, how I was able to find out my area of interest, all those things. Next. Study of journals, books, and other related information. This is nothing but the preliminary data collection. By saying preliminary data collection, I tell dear students, whenever we have to get into the field of research, this preliminary idea is very important. That's where we will get to know whether we can continue or not. There are several scientific journals, which I will be talking in a moment. In the later stages, I will talk. Books related to those topics, and other datas, that may be a newspaper article, that may be a reference to a thesis by your teacher or any of your known person, that may be reference to a project which has occurred in the recent times. Several things are there. So that study is very, very important. And then narrow down the research problem. Research problems have to be to the point. Of course, it has to be a broader one, yet that narrowing has to be there. I'll place an example, dear participants, how I was able to find out the research problem. My subject is physics. In physics, there are several divisions. Material sciences is there, astrophysics is there, condensed matter physics, electronics, quantum mechanics, classical mechanics, many such nuclear physics, many such things can be quoted here. In that, my specialization during the master's was material science. So obviously I chose to format in material science itself. In material science, there are several things. In those several things, I was able to select the glasses. Reason being, I had a professor by name Dr. Rajaram Krishna, who works in National College even now. Under him, I had performed a project on the glasses. So I thought I have a little bit of knowledge about the glasses and I had to go ahead. When it came to my research, I wanted a challenging one. I wanted to learn a lot. So I chose what is called as bioactive glasses because I saw not much focus was laid upon this idea, bioactive glasses. Of course, the very idea of bioactive glasses cannot be digested by many of the people. How can glasses be bioactive? They asked me. Again, in bioactive glasses, looking at the components of them, I chose what are called as the phosphate glasses. Phosphate being the main component of the glasses which I am working on. So this kind of pyramid, narrowing down in a funnel-like structure, the plethora of ideas we will be having to eliminate whatever is not suitable for us and finding out which best suits for us is the first step in order to get into the research. Well, now I would wait for a moment. If anyone wants to ask any question, I'll be ready to answer to the extent of knowledge I have on this field. Any questions here? even in the chat box it can be put.
Sir, how do you know that yes, research sir. Is possible or not in the beginning stage while selection?
That's what, sir. When I am doing the research, there are so many parameters which I have to address. First of all, in the scientific research, whether I have the facilities to prepare the sample which I am intending to do so. One example I'll give you. Few sample preparations might require huge temperatures, maybe around 1000 to 1500 degrees Celsius. Do I have access to such sophisticated equipments? That will be my first question. Then when it comes to the other steps, do I have access to all these things will be my next question. I think most of the people will have to address the first question. In the synthesis part itself, is it feasible for me? Is the data available? Looking at those parameters, one can decide whether I can pursue this particular topic or not. I want a response from you, sir. Is your question answered or any other insight is needed?
Yes, sir. Enough, sir. You answered my question.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Any other questions here? I think I can move ahead with the next slide. This is preview. Before getting into the research, what we are going to do. Next thing. Next slide is the process of research. Well, you know, I had shot a video on science by the title Science for All. There I had mentioned scientists are the people who sit in the labs. They become like sannyasis. They become like arrogant people. All those things I had told. Because researchers are demonstrated like that. Because, of course, research takes lot of effort, lot of hardships it takes. So here in the stages of research, this is a very famous cartoon called as Dexter's Laboratory. I like this to give an overview of how the research lab looks like. During the process of research, what happens? What should be the idea? This differs for different areas. This differs for different persons. One generalized view, let me try to give it here. Identify the research institute and collaboration. Like sir asked me, lot of ideas we might be having. Say for example, I prepare the best of the best sample of anything. Say a nanoparticle I prepare, or a glass I prepare, or a polymer I prepare. But my sample should be validated by a research institute by performing suitable experiments, suitable characterizations. Few things I will tell you. There is one instrumentation called as scanning electron microscope. Transmission electron microscope, TEM, is there. If we don't have access to them, then our samples will not be validated at all. Then there is no point in considering our research to be a fruitful one. That is why when we are doing the research, it is very, very essential to identify the institute and the collaboration. In the previous slide, while I was explaining, I told that most of the researchers are interdisciplinary, transdisciplinary, multidisciplinary. I being a physics person, it's not that I can do research by myself. I should have the help of chemists. I should have the help of mathematicians, by the computer experts, by the biologists for my research. Then this collaboration plays a very important role. We will have to mingle our hands with some other people. We have to help them for their research and seek help from them for our research. So identification of research institute as collaboration is there. Synthesis and characterization. I think I have spoken about synthesis and characterization many a times till now. The sample preparation and characterizing them. When characterizing, we have to get the ideas in the atomic levels, electronics level, molecular level, so that the sophisticated instrumentations are needed. That can be achieved by having the collaboration with the research institutes and other fellow researchers too. And then the analysis of the results. See, when some sample is characterized, there are several techniques for that. Once you get into the research, you will know. Once we obtain the results, our job is not complete. We will have to refer them with the standard values, identify what is special about this, identify what this particular is lacking, and the next challenge starts. ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತೀನಿ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ, ನಾವು ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮೊದಲ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ಏನಿದೆ, ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದನ್ನ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರೈಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅದು ಒಂದು ಉದ್ದಕ್ಕಿರುವಂತ ಬೋರ್ಡ್, ಡೈವಿಂಗ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಹತ್ತಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಸ್ವಿಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಪೂಲ್ಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದಾಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ರ ಆಳ ಎಷ್ಟು, ನೀರಿನ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಎಷ್ಟು, ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಹಾಟ್ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಆಗಕ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗತ್ತಾ, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ಮೇಲಿಂದ ನಾವು ಈಜೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್. And it continues again and again. Sometimes we will drown. Sometimes we will get up in a swimming pool. Similarly, during a scientific research, it's not that every time we get the expected results. Most of the times we get the unexpected ones. That's why I keep telling my fellow researchers, research is always expecting the unexpected. And after that, we will have to progress with it. Then the journey continues. That is what is the process of research. Again, I've put here, plan the experiment, experimenting, collecting and recording the data, coming to a conclusion, researching, think of an idea. See, ultimately, after everything is done, again, we have to think of an idea. And that's how the field of research takes us forward. After doing all this research, what we have to do will be the next question. Obviously, who will sit quiet after taking so much of hardship? That has to give some fruitful result. That is what I call as the review. In this, writing the research article, all the students here listen to this fact very clearly. There is a statement in our scientific research. Many people tell that whatever research you have done, how best it is, how interesting it is, how novel it is, how unique it is, will be useless if you don't publish. I'll give one example. Just I'll stop this screen and I'll try to share another screen now. Give me a moment. Yes, this is what I mean by a scientific research article. See, this is the title, Journal of Non-Crystalline Solids. It has other details also. Lists at Science Direct, it is a website. The title of this article is given as Influence of Zinc Ions on Structure, Bioactivity, Biocompatibility, and the Bacterial Potential of Melt-Derived and Gel-Derived Glasses from CaO, Calcium Oxide, Silicon Dioxide System. Alexandra, the different authors are there here. This is an abstract. I hope this is clear for all of you. See, just I will throw light on few main ideas, main headings of a research article. First thing we can see, an abstract. Abstract is summing up the entire research article to a paragraph. See, it states, I'll read out, several different compositions of zinc-containing glasses in CaO, SiO2 system were obtained by both traditional melting technique and salt gel method. Influence of zinc ions. Here the next sentence states, zinc oxide has a significant effect on glass structure, thermal properties, texture and bioactivity. EDX and ICP data showed the zinc ions reduce the glass bio. They're like this. Several of the things are there. Entire research article has to be brought into an abstract. Introduction. You see in the introduction, preliminary ideas related to that particular concept is given. Most importantly, dear students, identify the marks like this. 1, 2, 3 to 7, 8, 9, 10 are here. Here I see 11 to 13, 14. These are all the references. And all the scientific articles, paper should compulsorily have the references. That is what I meant in the preview. Study of journals and other related information. Like this, lot of papers have to be checked. Data collection has to be done. Only then the next stages will be helpful. As I said, introduction is there. And as I proceed, see, one point I would consider here. See, observe here. Received 28 September 2018. That means for that journal, this research article is sent on this particular date, received in revised form on 28 December 2018. Look at the time gap here. September, October, November, December, 3 months time. In this process, the authorities of this journal would have reviewed the paper. Check maadirthare complete aagi. Is this idea correct? Adralli enu copy aagilva? There's one thing called as plagiarism check. Copy aagirbardu anta. There are softwares available. If this paper is passed through the software, with every sentence, it will mark from where it has been copied and how much percentage has been copied. ಆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ನ ನೋಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ 3 months ಟೈಮ್, ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ರಿವೈಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಆ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರಿವ್ಯೂವರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ನ ಪೋಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಆ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಈ ಆಥರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಬೈ ಡಿಸೆಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೆನ್ ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ 31 December 2018. ಬೈ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಆನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನೆಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಬರಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಡೀತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ಗಿವ್ ಮೀ ಎ ಮಿನಿಟ್. After introduction, you can see materials and methods, preparation of glasses. This is just an explanation of how they are prepared. Adu material agbodu athwa characterization agbodu. Adhe riti XRD, X-ray diffraction, FTIR, all these things I don't want to take it up now because it will vary for different fields, the characterizations. MS, NMR, spectroscopy anta kelavu titles idave, thermal properties, all those things. You can see here, test of in vitro biocompatibility, antibacterial studies, all these things. Few images are there. Analysis, results and discussions. In the results and discussions, a detailed explanation would be given. Clear aagi kottirthare pratiyondunu. Yaake, iga for example, to tell you, image illide andre yathakoskara image heegide. Adu dappa aagirod yaake, sanna aagirod yaake. This is what I meant by analysis. ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರಿಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿರ್ತದೆ. ಸಿ, ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಮೆಜಾರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪೇಪರ್. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊನೆಯದಾಗಿ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅಂಡ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕೋಟೆಡ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಐ ಮೆಂಟ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಶಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಆರ್ಟಿಕಲ್, ಡಿಯರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್. Now I'll pause for a while. I'm going to give you the next two letters of the code. Meanwhile, if anyone has any questions, can ask me. I am writing the code here. Adralli yavadadru yaragadru question idre, you can ask me or you can put it in the chat box as well. Aga I'll be able to answer. And the host of this session, please tell me if there are any questions in the chat box. The next code would be, please make note of this. One second. I'm writing like this because the first letter is small letter P, lowercase letter P and capital letter N. It is PN. I repeat, till now the four letters of the code are announced. Yes. 2PN, capital letter S, digit 2, letter P, capital letter N. Yes, 2PN.
Is the code? Is the
code?
Is the code?
I hope I can proceed. So please mute those. I think there are no questions and I shall proceed. But again, I expected few questions anyway.
Sir,
let me move ahead. Write in the research.
Chetan sir.
Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Dot box il on message bandide. How to Sweta NS avrinda. How to choose a particular organization when we have options?
Okay. I'll be answering this question at the end, Sushmita NS. Because I have a few ideas to be given there. Aga nan answer man.
Avrinna on the sir. To get something better than what we have. Andre first yavado question ge answer
ma. Okay. I think that might be an answer for what is research. Why do we want to do research anta kelide kelirbodu adanna. Anyway, thank you Sushmita. Let me proceed. And I expect such type of interaction from other participants also. I shall proceed alva madam.
Okay sir. Then.
Yes. So the codes are declared. Let me move on to the next point, publishing in the journal. That's what I meant here. There are few standard journals. Nowadays, dear participants, there is a mafia going on for what is called as paid journals. They take the money and the papers are published without peer review or without having the standard of work, all these things. In the recent times, that has been a question. That has been in news also. Those things have to be taken care of. In the standard journals, what are called as the Scopus indexed journals, the publication is very important and it will have the weightage. Publishing in the journals, as I said, our scientific field at least does not value the unpublished work. So publishing whatever we have done is very, very important. And the last point, developing the profile. Developing the profile, by that I mean more publications we have, more value our profile will have. Most of the times nowadays, when a person who has done PhD is assessed, is looked for the standard of publications he or she has, rather than looking at the other concepts. One moment, I'll just erase this and move on to the next one. I think I shall proceed. Well, this is what I meant. Bharat Ratna, Professor Dr. CNR Rao, you can see his profile. This is in a website called as Google Scholar. For those who are interested, you can go and check this. We will have the profiles of all the prominent researchers. You see here few ideas. We have to see, not only cited by Antaide. Cited by means, in the recent slide, I showed you a research article where we saw a lot of references. It's not that when we have quoted one reference, entire concept of that reference is taken. Instead, one or two points of that paper might have included here. That might be used as supporting document for us. REET though, you just look at the number, for whatever Dr. CNR Rao's name is included among those papers, 119,738 citations have been done. I mean, so many people have quoted the messages or the inputs from his papers. Since 2015 itself, 36,962 citations have been done. That's what, dear students, dear participants, I would say, the standard of our work will be understood depending on these citations. If someone cites our work, it means there is something which has to be learned from our work. And H-index and I-10 index are the deciding parameters for that. It has a formula. Now, I don't want to comment on that. One particular paper quoted so many number of times will give such index. All these things are there. In many premier institutes, if any interview happens or for any project, this H-index and I-10 index is asked. So it is, that's what I meant by developing the profile. Profile development you can see CNR Rao, Professor of Chemistry, Materials Chemistry, Solid State Chemistry, these are all his papers. You can see one paper itself has been cited 3,642 times, 3,238 times, all these things. Moving on to the next slide, dear participants. Most of the students are the undergraduation in science. For all of them, you know, BSc degrees, there might be a lot of confusions. What has to be done next? How to choose all those things? Now I'm going to present an overview of what are all the opportunities after BSc. I see a question here. At the time of research, theoretical science and practice science important. Vinay RA has asked a question. Again, Vinay, answering to your question, it depends on your interest. Whether you want to pursue a theoretical one, if you want to pursue a practical one, it is up to you. In that process, you have to identify your strength. Are you good at theoretical, using the mathematical derivations, using various softwares, or are you good at performing the experiments and other things? That's individual one. Well, for the students of BSc, dear participants, again, as I said, I am going to place detailed description of what all can be done later.
Ketan sir, one question is, sir, Nafisa Sultan avrinda, how to choose the field of research? If we
do ಮುಂದೆ ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷ ವೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳಿ
how to choose a field of research if we do the research on same topic which already done by others and we are not aware of that is our research work will be valid.
Who has asked that madam?
Nafisa Sultana
avrige unmute maadkolla keli ond nimsha madam please unmute yourself.
Yes, madam.
Nafis Sultana.
Hello.
That's a very good question. Sir. Even I had such questions when I started my research, how to identify all these things and all. That's where I see the collection of data comes into picture, madam. When we narrow down the problem, say for example, as far as my research is considered, for the glasses to be prepared the matrix has a matrix andre yav yav component na eshtestu mix martivi anta when I search for the data I search on that particular concept details andre iga for example ondu calcium magnesium boron haki one glass martini anta ankoli aga nanu search maadbekadre I will search on these matrices itself then I get to know what research has been done what research to be done. Again, while reading the papers, the scientific journal articles, in the conclusion part, there might be a roadmap to the next research. That will get us the idea, whether what we are thinking is an old idea or a new idea. Agboda?
Okay, sir. Ah, okay, sir.
Okay, that's what I meant, madam. Idella nam godagbeku antandre that research the collection of a lot of information is required at the first moment.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thanks for that question. Students of BSc, I think you have to listen to these parameters. Interestingly, this might answer several of your questions. Student of BSc can take up the JAM examination. ನಾನು ಇನ್ನೂ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಜಾಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿ ಜಾಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎಂಟೈಟಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಪಾಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎಂಟೈಟಲ್ಡ್ ಟು ಡೂ MSc ಇನ್ IITs ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದಿ ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ PhD ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಐ ಶೋ ಯು ದಿ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ MSc IITs ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್ then a student of BSc can take up the JEST examination for doing a PhD integrated PhD research. A student of BSc can take up the CAT examinations for MBAs for doing the management courses. Of course, this is also a field which is having so much of interest as of now. A student of BSc can do an MCA as well or an MBA. Of course, B.Ed and M.Ed, most of you might be dreaming of becoming teachers, lecturers. For them, B.Ed and M.Ed degrees are suitable. A student of BSc, of course, the next option which is available is MSc. MSc can be done. Again, choosing the subject in MSc is according to your interest, your strength and all. After the MSc is done, the master's degree is done, all the students are entitled to take up the national eligibility test which qualifies them for the lecturership in the government institutions and also for the junior research fellowship JRF, both of which will be suitable for doing a PhD with a stipend. After the MSc, GATE exam can be taken. Again, I'm just moving this slide because I'm going to show you the websites here. Idanellavannu maadabodu. And other opportunities available for the student of BSc are listed out. Of course, more than anyone else, you yourself might be knowing all these ideas. Having said that, these are the links, dear students, for the premier institutions, JAM, JESH, IASC, IAA, Raman Research Institute, IUCA and all. At this moment, let me tell you one thing, dear students. you are staying very near to Bangalore. Gauribidnur is not so far away from Bangalore. Bangalore is the home for many standard premier research institutions in the country. We have Indian Institute of Science, IISc. We have Raman Research Institute. Indian Institute of Astrophysics is there. Indian Institute of Information Technology is there. Indian Institute of Management is there. So many research institutes we have in our city itself, in Bangalore itself. I think this is a boon for all of us to make use of the opportunities available in those institutes. Other than that, we have so many research institutes in other institutions as well. To give an idea, even our National College Jayanagar has been entitled as a research center from the Bangalore University. So many universities are doing. You will get to know about the idea. For a moment, I'll stop sharing this PPT and get into the website. Now, you can see here. See, I have the GATE examination details, links, all of them are given. One moment. See, this is the website of Raman Research Institute. One can make a note of all these things, or I'll try to copy all these links in the chat box, which you can notice. And this is the website of Indian Institute of Astrophysics, IIA. See, it makes a mention of your place as well. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗೌರಿ ಬಿದ್ನೂರ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಐಎಎಸ್ಸಿ, ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ related to the JAM examination, which I told now, joint admission test for MSc. The nodal institute is the Indian Institute of Technology, Kanpur. You can get more details on this. Then this is just examination details. I think all these things can be checked individually depending on your interests. Well, before I move on to the next slide, I would like to pose a burning issue here, dear participants. Research is very, very essential for an individual, for a place, for a country and world at large. Because, you know, when there are so many problems persisting, I'm not talking just in terms of scientific research, several other issues also, the contribution of the field of research in the development of a nation and world at large, as I said, is very, very crucial at this moment. That is why most of the students in this group might be having an inferiority complex that only the students who are in the city areas are good at research, nothing as of that. All of you can become the good researchers. All of you can become the good communicators. All of you can become the good contributors for the society, provided you have the zeal and enthusiasm to do something. I have known so many people who hail from very, very difficult backgrounds, socio-economically backward backgrounds, but they excel in the field of research like anything. We have people from North Karnataka who face the dearth of teachers. Their schools do not function properly, but they are very good at researches and the practical ideas. That is why, before I close the session, consider research as a passion, then making it a fashion. Why I tell this? Because the research has to be considered for the overall development of a country and yet to expand the knowledge horizons of each individual. But nowadays, doing a PhD is considered as a research. PhD is a route for research, dear students, dear participants. It's not the ultimate destination. Of course, all of us will have that wish to have the prefix DR in front of our names. It's good. But if you obtain a doctoral degree today, stop doing research tomorrow, you will get back to the normal student life or individual life the day after. So that continuous research has to be done, contributing to the knowledge. I would say research is a method of contributing a new knowledge to the sea of knowledge which is already existing. I think that would be very, very better. Now, before I give the next statement, I will reveal the last two digits of the code. I think I have told the four letters. The last two letters would be, again, I'll annotate here. All of you can notice, it is 6, digit 6, and small letter K. 6K, S2PN6K. All of you please make note of this because I'm going to erase this in a moment. I'm not going to keep it for a long duration of time. Only after erasing I will be able to move on to the next statement. I think it's clear. So one motivation all the students hailing from the rural background should have, that you can be the potential competitors for anyone else in the society. That is why, dear students, your college is contributing a lot for giving you information about all these things. Even we have made an attempt to our best to give you an insight to the field of research. The result should be seen in maximum number of students in this year to pursue research after you step out of the college. Only then all these efforts will bear fruit. So ultimately, I have one statement to make here, dear students. That is, let research be a journey, not a destination. Research does not end at all. One has to be a lifelong student and a lifelong researcher. Only then several purposes will be served. Having said all these things, I think I can take up the questions. Supriya madam, you can open the session for questions.
Okay, sir. Sir, chat box alli link hakide helbidi sir.
Dear participants, already there is a link for downloading the e-certificate. There you will have to give your name. Please be aware when you state your names, spelling should be correct, spacing should be correct, because whatever you type there will be appearing on the certificate. There won't be no change. Full name and the college name should be given as you require on the certificate. So if some participants here want your name in the capital letters, give them in the capital letters. If you want them to be bold, give them in the bold letter, but give it as it is required, and then you allow to select the code, only then the e-certificate will be generated. I think the things are clear. At least now, can I see all your videos? Even the... Someone has put here, it's asking webinar code. That's what I have been telling from the beginning. But I told the code part by part. I see a question in the chat box from Anu KS, sir. What basic skills should be developed before entering the research? Anu, let me make the concept clear. First, you have to question everything. Don't accept anything without having a proper analysis. I think that's the basic idea which has to be developed by a researcher. If you have the habit of questioning, you will analyze the things. Then, critically, one has to analyze. Right? It's not that you accept all the points you study or you are being told by someone else. You have to go through it critically. Is it correct? Point by point. I keep telling the students, when we are the science communicators, when we are studying science, each and every word matters in our communication. We cannot say longer or shorter. We have to specify the length. We cannot say farther or nearer. We should always specify the distance. That is what science requires and science is.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Is research valid that is not done through institution but done individually in a systematic way? Yes, that's what I said. The research will be validated depending on the publication you make. I think Nagendra Prasad has asked this question. I hope his question is answered. Is research a permanent solution to a problem? Now, I think there is a discussion in the question itself. Now, I have to ask, is the problem permanent? See, when the situations change, new things have to be taken. See, who has thought that one day we will be having an online session like this? This situation is originated because of the pandemic that is going on. So I think at that point, the research will matter. And what are the methodologies to conduct research on human beings? When it is on human beings, we will have to fix the parameter, whether it is based on behavior of human beings, biology of human beings, or psychology of human beings. Depending on that particular field, have particular methodologies that you will come to know when you enter the field. I see the session was very informative. Sumanta HS, thank you, sir. At the time of research, how much salary is given? Vinay RA. Of course, it's not called as a salary when you take up research. It's called a stipend. That depends on the deciding authorities, Vinay. But now the scholars are getting somewhere around 15 to 25,000 in between them. And it also depends on, this one point I have to tell. In few research institutes, there would be projects from Department of Science and Technology or IASC for some premier, for funded research projects will be there. A good amount will be allocated. And in that amount, one part will be set as a honorarium or stipend for the scholars. It depends. It has to be decided by the guide and the operating authority. I see Ramanjanamma, your explanation is very good, sir. Thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you for your response. Sushmita, how to choose? Yeah, how to choose one particular organization when we have options? Yes, Sushmita, you had asked this question earlier also. The thing is, again, it depends on few factors like the guide or the supervisor under whom you are working is in which institute. Does the research institute have all the equipments and facilities required for your research? All these things have to be taken care of. Manjunath Gowda, thank you, sir, for providing valuable information. Thank you, sir. It's very nice session. Thank you. Session was very helpful for me. I can deliver the same information to my very, very good madam. And it's expected also to pass on the information. Thank you so much. My interesting in doing research. Very motivating. Thanks for inspiring the information. Very good, Meenakshi. I guess you'll be the good researcher in the future. I think I missed few comments. How to find a best research guide? Kalai Chelvan has asked this question. Well, sir, for this, my supervisor under whom I did my research methodology classes told me how to find the best research guide is the first problem in doing a PhD, at least, if not a research. I would rather say no research guides are good, no research guides are bad. PhD is mostly on developing a rapport with our guide while doing the research. When we have a good impression from our guide, definitely our works would be easier. We will have to catch the pulse of our guides. And reaching to his or her expectation is always a challenge for us. maximum how many years we can do research. That's what I said. Research is a journey, it's not a destination. Research has to be a lifelong one. Dr. CNR Rao's example, which I gave now, he is running 85 plus, still he is an active researcher. We should choose guide first or the organization. Sushmita NS, I think it's both matters, but you will have to prioritize whether guide is important or organization is important. Vinay Arya, I didn't get your question. At the time of complete of research, how to popular in our country, in our society? Can you please repeat that question by unmuting yourself? What are the basic causes to find to do research? These questions are not clear. If you can ask me directly, it will be better. Very well presented, sir, which was very helpful for younger students. Seema, thank you, madam. Thank you so much, sir. I got one more. Thank you, madam. Thank you so much. If we have better guide, but the organization that have the requirements that we need, what can be done? Collaboration can be done, Sushmita. If you have the guide and the organization. See, let me tell you, no organization will have all the facilities you need during the research. Collaboration is very, very important during the research. So, if you are very favorable with the guide, you can go for the collaboration. State-wise collaboration, city-wise collaboration, national collaboration, all these things can be done. Yes. Thank you, Sushmita, for attending this. What is bioactive glass? Well, as I said, madam, it's my research area. The glass which is having the bioactive properties. One example I would state here is, we have some materials called as the graft materials. Whenever a person undergoes a fracture in the bone, those graft materials are placed there, which will enable the genesis of the bone tissue, regeneration. Can the glasses replace those graft materials is the question. So bioactive glasses will have applications on the area where we are targeting. That may be a teeth or a bone. The concept which I am working is for the bone tissue engineering. Our PhD is nothing when we get a proper guide to do research. Is that true, sir? How can you say your PhD is nothing? It's everything. You ask any PhD scholar, they will dispute with that statement. I would rather demystify that. Of course, a proper guide is needed. Again, it has to be a collective responsibility of both guide and the student. If the guide is very good, you don't do anything, then what's the point there? So, guru is always important. Following the steps of guru is much important. If two persons doing research on same topic without knowing that, then many things may look similar in their articles, then there may be a problem after publish of article, how to solve those types of issues, and also how can we know is someone doing research on the same topic of ours. Last question though I answered. When we are searching for the research articles, it has to be always a search on that particular idea, then we will get to know what amount of research has been done on that particular thing. Then coming to the publication part, two persons doing research on same topic without that, then may things may look similar. That's where the publication comes into picture. If you are clear that two persons are doing exactly the same research, one who publishes first will get the advantage. So that's why we should not keep our ideas within ourselves. We should publish as and when it is completed. Research scholars spend a lot of time on literature survey and choose the topic of research. Why can't the guide choose a topic of relevance and set the direction for the scholar? This saves a lot of time. Yes, sir, definitely. This is a message for any research guides. That's what I said. Narrowing down the problem is very important. Of course, this is a suggestion rather than a question. It depends on the guides, how they go about their students. Can a MSc physics student research on biology or math and still get a doctorate degree? As far as the PhD in subject is considered, it should be physics. Based on which subject you have chosen for a master's degree, But as I said, in the earlier stages, it can be transdisciplinary. Coming to my topic itself, I am doing a PhD in physics, but mine is mostly based on biophysics. So it is PhD in physics only, because during the admission, the criteria is that the scholar has to choose the topic which they have studied in their post-graduation. Thanks for providing each one of us to really know about the information. It was really a gateway to start the research in our care. Thank you. Thank you so much, madam. Please once again send to all webinar quotes or explain once again, sir. Supriya madam, can I again announce the quote or what?
Sir, one time you can, sir.
One time, okay. All of you please be alert. I'm going to announce the quote. No repetition at all. These are like the golden words. The code is S, capital letter S, digit 2, small letter P, capital letter N, digit 6, small letter K. S, 2, P, N, 6, K is the code. So, madam, can I conclude the session?
Yes, sir.
Just a minute, madam. Please give me a minute. One moment.
Chetan sir, please conclude your.
Yes sir, one moment. I'm doing so. In 1 or 2 minutes, I'll conclude the session. Madam, there is a message for the feedback link. So from one person called as Praveen N. Praveen, you can go back in the chat section and find out. The link has been provided already. If there are any confusions, you can contact the coordinator. There's one last question I would like to take. How to choose our guide? How was that process? For me, though, I had known the guide previously. Before getting into the doctoral degree, I had a conversation with my guide. We had shared our ideas. Only then I stepped into. That's what, that takes a time. That's the main point. Anyway, I think we are running out of time. You can contact us personally over the mail. I would be able to help you in this regard. Well, having said all these things, dear participants, as I said, I expect that the research should be a journey, not a destination, owing to so many conundrums that exist in our world today. Having said that, all of you were very lovely audience. The interactions were very good. And I thank Supriya Madam for organizing this webinar. I thank my guru, who was my teacher during my undergraduate days, Professor V. Jagdish, for having invited me this. Thank you so much, sir. Of course, you know, we have learned a lot of things from you. We had spent so many good times in the college. And I'm very happy that you gave me this platform to share ideas. For all these participants, thank you so much, sir. And at the outset, before concluding, I thank the management and all faculty members, people who are responsible for organizing this webinar. Thank you so much. Let the spirit of research be in all of us, and all the students emerge as the important people in the society. Thank you so much, madam.
ಓಕೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಪೂಜ್ಯ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಚ್ ನರಸಿಂಹರನ್ನ ನೆನೆಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮನ ವೋಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಡಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ವಿತ್ ಚೇತನ್ ಸರ್ ಪರ್ಮಿಷನ್, ವಿ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಎ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್.
ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಸರ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೈಟಿಂಗ್.
ಜನರಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೀತಕ್ಕಂತ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ವಿಷಯನು ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಷಯನ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂತೀವಿ. ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಡೀಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾನು ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕಾರಣಗಳಾಗ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ ನಡೀತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಷಯಗಳಾಗ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲದೂ ಕೂಡ ಡೀಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನೇ ನಾನು ಗೇಟ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೇಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಓಪನ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದೀನಿ. ಇದು ರೈಟರ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ನನಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಕಾಲರ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನನಗೆ ಇದು ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಇದನ್ನ ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತ ದೇಶದ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿಗಳಿದ್ರು, ಯಾರಂದ್ರೆ ಋಷಿಮುನಿಗಳು. ಈ ಋಷಿಮುನಿಗಳು ತಪಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್. ಅವ್ರೊಂದ್ ಮರ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರಲ್ವಾ, ಅದೇ ನಾವು ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿಬಹುದು. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಅವ್ರು ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್. ಹಿ ಇಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಈವೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೇಚರ್. So that's the first research has been done all over the world is by Indians. But all the research publishers, what we have publications from that munis has been stored in the library. It is in Sri Lanka. But it is got destroyed in the period of Britishers. Why? Because they don't want Indians to become scientists. Idu agide. ಆದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ ಹೆಚ್ಚನ್ ಅವರು ಇದನ್ನ ಮನ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು 1964 ಈ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ನ ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಯಾವುದೇ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಡಿಪ್ಲೊಮಾ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಾಲೇಜಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ BSc ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಅವ್ರು ಆಗಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇದರ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿ. ನಾವು ಪಾಠ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ತಿಳಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಚಾರ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದರ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ನ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಪಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೊಂದು ಅವಕಾಶ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಅದನ್ನ ಈ ವೆಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಸಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸೆಮಿನಾರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಟ್ಟಂತ ಚೇತನ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಪರವಾಗಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೇನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಚೇರ್ಮನ್ ಅವರಾದಂತ ನಾಗರಾಜಪ್ಪ ಸರ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಗೆ ಮೇನ್ ಮೋಟಿವ್ ಯಾರಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆದಂತ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ GB ಪಾಂಡುರಂಗ ನಾಯಕ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರು, ಹಾಗೇನೆ GC ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆದಂತ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ MV ಕೃಷ್ಣಮೂರ್ತಿ ಸರ್ ಅವರು, ಮತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಟೀಚರ್, ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಅದು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾನು ತುಂಬಾ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆ ಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಭಿಮಾನ ತುಂಬಾ ಆಭಾರಿ ಆಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಇದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಕಾರಣ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಜಗದೀಶ್ ಸರ್, ವೈಸ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ AES ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್, ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ HOD ಆಫ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೌರಿಬಿದನೂರು ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್. ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ತಲೆ ಕೆಡಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ವಿಷಯ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಬೇಕು, ಹೊಸದಾಗಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಏನೋ ಕಲಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಇಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಅವರಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕುಮಾರಿ ಸುಪ್ರಿಯಾ ನಾಯಕ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ತಿಳಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಹಾಗೇನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನ ಕೊಲೀಗ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಹರೀಶ್ ಸರ್ ಅವರು ಮತ್ತೆ ಹೇಮಲತಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನ ಅರ್ಪಿಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಇಷ್ಟು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಾಗೇನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಸಹೋದ್ಯೋಗಿಗಳಾದಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಾಫ್ಗು, ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾನ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಾಫ್ಗು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಲೈಬ್ರರಿ ಸ್ಟಾಫ್ಗು ನಾನು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು ಯಾರಿಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ, ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ. ಆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇದರ ಏನು ಔಟ್ಕಮ್ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ನ ಅವ್ರು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತಾ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್
ಸರ್. ಒಂದೇ
thanks for all participation for the participants and thank you Chetan sir idu successful agiddike tumba new corner agidira hage navu inna ee tara webinars conduct martivi anta helta session na close madana sir thank you sir thank you.